Hey guys, it's Donna with Resale Tips and Tales, and today I bring you my sales from June and July. Okay, so sorry for the delay in the June sales, but I figured I would go ahead and squeeze them together with July. It's been a little bit of a slow summer for me, but only because I have been out of town. I've been traveling a lot, so I haven't really had a lot of time to put into my online business as much as I normally do, but that's the nice thing about an online business is you have the flexibility to take care of your family, do the fun things you want to do, and put as much time into your business when you want to do that. So we'll go ahead and get started. I've decided, since there's so many to share, so I've kind of handpicked the items that I felt would be the most useful for you guys to know about, either the higher profit or the brand or the items that I sold. So let's go ahead and get started. These are in no particular order. Again, they're just from June and July. So we'll go ahead and just get started. Sorry. All right. So this first item here, I love this brand of puzzle. They've been around for years, and the older the puzzle typically brings you the better amount of money. This is Springbok, and this is just a car puzzle, and honestly I didn't even have the count of the puzzle pieces. Sometimes I'll put the puzzles together, but life is crazy with kids, so it's very rare that I put the puzzles together. I just put in there that I'm unsure if it's complete or not. So this one here, I only paid 50 cents for this at a church yard sale, and I sold it for $20. Wanna say hi?
Hi.
So after fees and everything else, I made $16. I love you too, sweetie. Go on and play. So I made $16.63 on that. So that is pretty cool. I have sold some that are more expensive than that. My best one was a Christmas puzzle. So look out for the Christmas ones. And that one I think sold over or close to $100. So some of them are worth some money. And that one was even missing some pieces. So look out for the Springbok puzzles. This next one here, if you've been watching my recent videos, I really love this design of material. This is by J. Crew, which is also a plus. But this is called Madras. It's a patchwork plaid type of pattern, M-A-D-R-A-S. So anything you see in this that has the stitched patchwork in the fabric is really worth picking up if it's in good condition. It's just a pair of shorts by J. Crew. I did pay $3 for these, but I sold them for $20. So my profit on that item was $11.10 after all the fees and shipping. So I always aim for at least $10 profit. I feel like that at least is worth my time that I've put into the item. So when you're shopping, just kind of keep in mind, what is your dollar amount of profit that you want to make on an item, just based on how much time you have. This item here is a cute little pair of shoes. I actually debated on keeping these myself because I thought they were so cute and they fit me so well, but I'd rather make the money. But this is Lucky Brand, and these are a blue snakeskin ballet flat, so that's why they're so cute. But I did pay $4 for these, but I sold them for $25, so I really couldn't turn that down. So after all the fees and profit, I made $13.85. This is a good brand, always is for me. This is a Polo Ralph Lauren Sport, but these are really unique tan suede loafers, and I had a lot of watchers on this. I paid only $2.50 for these, and I sold them for $20. So that was a great profit as well for $14.16. This brand, if you've seen my other videos, you know that I do pick it up if it's a unique item. Typically Hollister or Abercrombie and Fitch don't sell well if they're just basic items. But this one here was so unique. This is like a white beaded, had gems and stuff on it, a tank top, and I thought it was really pretty. Only paid $2 for it as well, so always keep in mind the prices that you're paying for things. And I sold it for $15. So that one was a pretty decent price. That one I sold profit of $8.22. So that was cool. Let's see what else I have here. This is by Victoria's Secrets, believe it or not, but it is a insulated cooler tote, and it was brand new with a tag on it. I did pay $5 for this, again, at a church, like, flea market type thing, and I sold it for $20, so I was happy to get that. I was actually surprised. I thought I would get more for it, and I sat on it for a little while, and so in the end, I made $11, and I did sell that one on Poshmark, so that's great. Poshmark's been doing pretty well for me. I've also kind of thrown some Mercari in there. If you haven't heard of Mercari, check them out as well. What I love about Mercari and Poshmark is their fee structures are so simple. They just take a percentage out, and then you can decide whether or not on Poshmark you the buyer pays the shipping. On Mercari you can decide either way. I just think it's a whole lot easier with the fees and compared to eBay and PayPal. It just gets kind of complicated. So if you're a new seller out there, maybe Mercari or Poshmark might be a better choice for you to start on for simplicity. This one was really cool too. Everybody's into the retro 80s look right now, especially with Stranger Things and all that going on. So this kind of reminded me of that, but this is by Adidas. And I did a little bit of research to find out what the name of it was. And it's called a Breeze Tropical Clip Snapback, strapback. But I only paid $2.50 for this, and I did sell it for $20 on Poshmark. So in the end I made $13.50 on that hat. This is a really nice purse here. This is by LL Bean, and this is a canvas messenger style and leather purse. It was such great condition. I bought this at a yard sale. Only paid a dollar for it. It was crazy. And I did sell that for $25 on Poshmark, so I made $17.20 on that. These are just super cute. I picked these up basically just because of what they look like, but they're by a brand called Dizzy. I had never heard of that before, but they have peacocks on them. How cute is that? And they have these like rubber bows on them. The whole shoe was made of like this plastic rubbery material. I did pay $2 for these. Hey, Izzy. And I sold them for $18. And so I made about $12 on those on Poshmark. All right. This next item here I also picked up at a yard sale. Yard sales are wonderful during the summertime. If you live in a warm climate, I'm kind of jealous because you probably have yard sales year-round. But this is just a Coach Basic pouch. It actually had some damage. I believe it was on the strap. But I did end up selling it for $18.50. And I made about $11 on that. This brand I love, this is Brooks Brothers, and this is just a black basic polo shirt, but I think what made me money is because it was an XXL. The larger the size, sometimes the more money you can get for an item. Paid $4.05 for this, and I sold it for $18, which gave me a profit of $10. Okay, so this next item here, these are just, I had never heard of this brand either. This is a pair of sandals called Vionic. I don't know if you've ever heard of those before, but they're like a hiking sandal, I guess. But I only paid $4.99 for these, and I sold them for $38. So again, check all the brands out. If it looks like it's a high quality item, pick it up, research it, and buy them. So I'm glad I picked that item up, and I made over $25 on that item. Here's another Victoria's Secrets item. This is by their brand called Pink. This is just a basic gray t-shirt. And I think it said love across the front. Paid $3.38 for this, and I sold it for $20. So Victoria's Secrets is still in. So make sure you keep your eye out for those, especially the graphic items. This item here, I have been sitting on these forever. These are a 7 For All Mankind jeans. I have a really hard time pushing jeans. Some people love jeans and selling them, but I don't have very good luck with them. But I did pay $3 for these, and I ended up selling them for $20. So I eventually got my money back on these, but I sat on them for a very long time. This is a new brand for me as well. This is by Custo Barcelona, C-U-S-T-O, and this is a really cute tiger purse, and it was in great condition. It was brand new condition. I paid $4 for this, and I sold it for $25, so keep your eye out for this. I just sold a t-shirt in this brand as well. Another Victoria's Secrets. This here is a gray hoodie with the sequins, and it was like a leopard print. Always look for the sequins with Victoria's Secrets. It seems like the flashier it is, the better it sells. Only paid a dollar for this at a yard sale, and I sold it for $45, and it was even kind of worn out. I was really surprised that I sold it for that much, but they're in high demand. So I ended up making a profit of over $37 for that. So that was awesome. Let's see here. What else do I have? This is a really neat item. I love little, tchotchke pins, like little people collect them, like the lapel pins, I guess you would call them. And I always look around the register to see if I can find some, because sometimes they can sell for really well. This one here is the Olympics from Salt Lake in 2002, and I ended up picking up 3 at that time. This is the first one I sold, actually. I still have 2 more left, but I only paid 34 cents for this, which is a nice thing about pins as well. So people that collect them, they're the ones that you want to target. I sold it for $16. Now, the funny thing is, this one was kind of weird. So I had it listed for, I think, $10, and the person offered me $16. And I've heard stories like this to kind of be wary of people that offer you more than what you have the item listed for, because sometimes they'll scam you somehow. But that wasn't the case. The person paid for it. I shipped it out. They left me positive feedback. So I don't know what happened there, if they pushed the wrong button or whether they really just wanted to pay more for the listing. I don't know. It was really weird, but I'll take it. So for that item, I made over $10 with all the shipping taken out and the fees and everything. So I don't know, but keep your eye out for those little collectible pins, the lapel pins. Here is another lucky brand, but these were jeans. These are dungarees, and these sold pretty quickly for me. These I paid $3.75 for, and I sold them for $25. So I guess some jeans do sell. Let's see here, moving along here. This is a brand that I've kind of been in love with lately. It's Crocs, and I know that sounds really silly, but it's not the ugly, clunky Crocs. These are the more decorative Crocs. These here were like a really pretty green and yellow sandal, so look out for the unique versions. But I paid $5 for these, and I did sell them for $36. So these are still in style, apparently, this brand. Maybe they're comfortable with the big rubber bottoms. I don't know. I don't wear them myself, but I made over $16 on them. So still a good brand to pick up. This item is a unique item for me, at least. It's Lauren, Ralph Lauren, but I was at this cute little local thrift store and they had a 50-cent rack, or no, 25-cent rack. And this, I think, accidentally got put on there. When I went to the register, I put it on the counter. She goes, oh, that's not 25 cents. And I said, oh, okay, it's no big deal. Just put it back. She goes, you know what? You're a new customer. We'll go ahead and give it to you for 25 cents. So I took it. Now, it had a lot of pilling. The material needed to be cleaned up on it, but I got my little sweater shaver out and I cleaned it all up and I ended up selling it for $15. So I was really happy with that, with only a 25 cent investment. So ended up making almost $12 on that item. Here is an Abercrombie & Fitch, speaking about that earlier, but what was unique about this is this lacy, like, pink outfit, this shirt. I only paid $2 for this, and I had actually shipped this out, and someone returned it because it didn't fit. So I lost a little bit on the shipping on this, because I had to pay both ways on that situation, but I turned around and sold it for $30, which was more than I had sold it for the first time, so that made me happy. So I still ended up making over $18 on that item. Let's see here, a few more things. This is a great brand of sandals. This is Teva, T-E-V-A, but this was just like a strappy sandal. I only paid $1.50 for this, which was really crazy, and I sold them for $38, so I thought that was awesome. These are these hiking sandals, so make sure you keep a lookout for those as well. So I made over $22 on that item. I love Kate Spade, which is what this next item is. This is Kate Spade Saturday, which is a clothing line that they have. I think it's a lower end clothing line. And I really wish this had fit me, but it did not. But I did pay $10 for this, which was a little bit much, maybe because I love Kate Spade. I had my blinders on. I probably should not have paid that much for it. And I turned around and sold it for $26. So just be careful when you have your own brands that you like, that, you don't pay too much for items, but I at least made my money back on that. I made $10. So that was good. Here's another Brooks Brothers purple plaid shirt, something basic, men's shirt. Only paid $1.54, which was great, and I sold it for $15. So, again, made over my $10 profit, which is what I love. This item here is a Pittsburgh Penguin hoodie, so always look out for team items. Let's see here. I only paid $1 for it, so that was also a plus, and I sold it for $15. And I think I sold that on Poshmark, which kind of surprised me, because men's clothing sometimes sit on Poshmark for a little bit longer, but I did make $11 on that. Let's see here. Couple more things I want to share with you. Another pair of Crocs. So this is another one. These are black basic wedges, but they were brand new. Now they did have some like pop marking in them, almost from when they were stored. But I just disclosed that in the listing. Paid $6.72 for it, so a little bit much on the high end, but I did sell them for $20. So I made just close to $10 on those, and I sold those also on Poshmark. So as you see, my Poshmark is picking up, which makes me so happy. And then the last item I wanted to share with you guys are these really fun shoes. These jumped out on the shelf at me because they're bright pink. But they're by a brand called Ruby Shoe, S-H-O-O. But they were brand new. Nobody had worn them. And let's see here. I don't have down what I paid for those. Well, shoot. Oh, wow. I did sell them for $25. So look out for new brands. That's, I guess, the theory of this video, is that if you don't know the brand, look it up. Make sure you always have your phone with you when you're in the thrift store, so that you can look it up really quick on the eBay app. It's so simple to see whether or not it's a good seller or whether you should pick it up. Don't be scared of new brands. So that's all I have for you guys today. Sorry I'm kind of mumbling a little bit, but I have summer brain right now. I'm like still on vacation, I think, but I didn't want to delay the videos any longer for you guys. But if you have any questions about the brands, please leave them below, or if you want to share with me what your sales were for June and July. Also, make sure that you like the videos and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, until next time, happy thrifting.